You have great photos in the book. You have old headshots. These are real headshots. Can you take us through these?
Yes. Well, that's the innocent girl next door.
Okay, and then moving on, we have...
And that is a surprise girl
Very
next
nice.
Door.
Very nice, okay.
And that's the girl on the phone next door. And that's the nude girl with the medical alert bracelet next door. That photo says, I'm hot, I'm single, and I'm allergic to penicillin. So that got me a lot of work.
You know what I'm surprised to learn is just about all of the SCTV cast members are Canadian, famously so, and then I find out that you're not Canadian.
No, I dedicate my book to Canada, though, because I dedicate it to Canada, my career, my husband and my children, Justin Bieber. I dedicated it to all of that because my career started in Canada. But no, I'm from Portland, Maine. I'm Armenian. Mm-hmm. Did you know that?
I did. I found out you were Armenian. My assistant is Armenian.
Oh, is that true?
She very proudly told me, wow. She was like, you know, we have Andrea Martin. She's ours. She's
yeah. Armenian. Oh, I love that. What's her last name?
Movsesian.
Yeah, all Armenian names end with I-A-N. You know who else is Armenian? The Kardashian sisters.
Yes. Yeah. Congratulations,
wonderful.
By the way. Yeah.
They are, honestly.
Congratulations, yeah.
They're bringing such positive energy to the country.
Yeah.
That Armenia's thinking of changing their national anthem to I Like Big Butts and I Cannot Lie.
You know, I love you also talk about your kids going to school in the same school as Meryl Streep's kids and Dustin Hoffman's kids.
Yeah.
And you used to have to drop them off and you almost feel like you were in a competition with Meryl Streep and Dustin Hoffman.
Well,
dropping off your kids.
Well, you know, I was a very anxious parent. I was very overly protective, and yes. So I sent them to a school that Meryl Streep and Dustin Hoffman sent their kids to. And I would watch Meryl Streep as she dropped off her kids and realized that my goodbyes paled in comparison. Her goodbyes were the goodbyes of a real mother. They were subtle, and mine were over the top and desperate. Mommy loves you. Mommy loves you! There wasn't a dry eye in the playground as Miss Streep dropped
yes.
her lunches off to her kids and with the brave determination of her awesome Oscar-winning role as Sophie, made the choice to get in her Volvo station wagon and drive away. I was very competitive with Meryl Streep. In fact, there was a storytelling hour every week, and I wanted to tell, so I hired a dialect coach, not to be undone by Meryl Streep and Dustin Hoffman. I'm walking here, said the Velveteen Rabbit. Bon appetit, said the very hungry caterpillar. Yes.
You're torturing yourself.
Competitive, very competitive.
Very competitive. I had a story like I once when my daughter was about, I think she was in elementary. No, she was in I want to say she was is before kindergarten even.
Yeah, preschool.
Preschool. They asked me to go in and read to her class.
Yeah.
So I went in and I started doing like shtick and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah.
And the kids
just
the kids are
laughing.
No, they were actually started to laugh. And I came home and I said to my wife, I was killing in there. And she looked at me like, you freak.
There's my audience.
They're like fetuses. What are you supposed to read the book? Well, and I was like, yeah, but I was doing this and doing that. And I had them on the ropes.
It's Mrs. Fogel's tiny town. Come on in and hang around. Anything for attention.
Anything. It's so sad. What's become of us?